Well, my wind system broke my flowers. And now they're bunny hopping. Anyway, hello gamers, game developers, enthusiasts, and future me. I'm excited to share that I'm finally starting my solo game developer journey. After making plenty of 3D donuts and Blender tutorials and frying my old computer doing renders, I think I'm ready to put it all together. So, this January 2024, I finally decided to get serious about game development and launch my channel. Say hello to Bunyip Hutch, where every month I will share my progress, tutorials or assets, and get feedback from you. As an avid gamer, the idea of making my own game always seemed really cool, so I decided to level up my own life and upgrade from a 9-to-5 full-time job to the uncertain but exciting path of a game developer. So, with plenty of support from my friends and family, I'm ready to make my first open-world RPG. Well, maybe not this year. As much as I would love to create the next Fallout, I promised myself to focus on small projects like puzzles or co-op games to publish on itch or Steam. I want to have experience of completing a small game before it can really go big. While I enjoy playing pixel art games, I don't think my art skills will ever reach that far, so I'll probably stick to my 3D donuts. Lately, I have been inspired by other solo game devs and how far they got in their projects in just a few months. Nectar is a unique sunflower puzzle game with cute and cozy visuals and a little bumblebee companion. Nightstones is a stunning adventure RPG where you can switch day to night at the click of a button. Resttore has a fully functional cool ocean with lifelike buoyancy and floating physics. Now let me show you the game I'm trying to make this year. I'm in the process of making a multiplayer lumberjack game with wonky tree physics. Currently, I have a few versions I'm prototyping to make sure the game will feel fun, so it may be level-based like Overcooked or have some PvP battle royale elements like Party Animals, but we'll see soon. And just to add, I have no previous experience with game development, coding, or art, but I'm still diving in headfirst because that's how learning new skills works. This is a passion project for me. I've always wanted to pursue the arts, but never made the time. I have dabbled with digital art, 3D modeling, writing, and some other hobbies. So in the end, the game dev life feels like a natural combination of all of these skills. Now back to our lumberjacks. As this is my first game project, I want to learn a lot and be able to apply it in the future games. Not to lose sight of the project, I have three main priorities for the game. Number one, it must be fun to play. Number two, it must look nice, cozy or stylized. Number three, it must feel smooth from movement to multiplayer optimization. How am I going to do it all? Easy. Well, not easy, but probably doable. I will use Unreal Engine 5 visual scripting blueprints, which require no coding knowledge, but do allow you to write your own code if you know C++. For assets and animations, I will use Blender to make my objects from scratch. For art, I have YouTube ArtSchool by Mark, where I can learn color theory, composition, and character design. For sound, I'll probably just make some beep boop robot sounds in FL Studio 21. And anything else, I'll just Google. Thanks for making it this far, you're a real one. Next month, I will showcase some of my game props and design, so I hope to see you then.